a boiling point with the Davis brothers, Tom and Mike. They really have it in for you guys, and a lot of fans are asking why. I'm going to ask you why, Terry.
Well, because the Davis brothers are just like that, Bonnie. They're dirty, they're cheaters, they're, as far as I'm concerned, they're nothing. But you know what? I will admit this. They know how to wrestle, okay? Most of all, they know how to cheat. They've cheated Chaz before. They've cheated me before. But we're putting our heads together. Isn't that right, Chaz?
We've seen these matchups. You won a match. They, of course, cheated and won a match. But now there's a final showdown coming. Chaz, what do you expect?
I expect to get out there and give it our best, and we're going to give them a show. We're going to give them a run for our money.
We expect them to be sneaky, Terry. What do you got planned?
Oh, we're not going to tell you that, Bonnie. We may have a little bit of sneakiness inside of us, you know? We're talking, we're planning, and I guarantee you this, we're not going to lose willingly.
Dirty Davis Brothers.
Champions. I know they always have to cry and tell. I know he's going to global headquarters all the time. This kid right here. Oh, I should be champion. I should be champion.
Well, actually, there is a rumor that Chaz will get another title shot because of all the calls coming into the 900 hotline.
Well, the calls shouldn't make any difference, Joe. It's what happens in that squared circle. And he did get defeated. Yeah, you said he held it for what, 5 scant days?
Well, actually, 3 days, actually.
3 days? Well, my goodness.
But now, you know,
what are we going to do, stand up and play a violin for him?
Well, on the GWF hotline, the fans can leave a comment. And I will say this, there's been a lot of people calling, literally thousands, saying, shot, and I understand that there's a good chance it's going to happen.
Well, he was so lucky at the beginning of it.
Look at that move. Garvin, a beautiful move there. Garvin now is up to staring down. Look at the look on Garvin's face, determination. He is determined that he and Chaz are going to do well in this match. Now, these two teams have faced each other now three times. One match went to Chaz and Garvin, one match went to the Davis brothers, one match ended in a double DQ. So you might say this is like the rubber match of the feud here, and who's going to go ahead in this feud? The Davis brothers, you know, you never know what they have on their mind, that
guy. Exactly, Joe. And you know, amazing as it is, you know, for wrestling fans, now I'm not demeaning wrestling fans by any means.
Oh, of course not.
No. But you know, it makes me, it nauseates me the way they rally around Terry Garvin, Wild Bill Irwin, Kerry Garvin, when all those guys were with me.
Look at this. Where's he going to go with him? He brings him out. Beautiful monkey grip on Mike Davis by Terry Garvin. There's the tag, and in comes Chaz. Dropkick now puts Davis back into the ropes. Chaz says, I've got him. The referee says, you got to lift him up.
Well, that's illegal.
Chaz thrown over the top rope. And as we have said, that is not a DQ. And now what are they doing? They're going to work.
What's on this?
Terry Garvin. They've got to. What's the Lightning Kid doing down here? The Lightning Kid is at ringside. What's he got? He's got a roll of tape. What are they doing?
I don't know what it is, Joe, but I love it.
They have got Terry
Garvin. I love it.
What are they doing? Stomping on Chaz. This has got to be something that was planned. This is a plan by the Lightning Kid.
I knew it was premeditated.
But look at this. He's got a fat handful of money.
I don't know what to do, but I love it. I don't know what's going on. But
he has got a handful of money. And he stalks Chaz while they're tying. Why are they tying Terry Garvin into the rope?
Well, he needs to be tied anyway. That's fine. That's good.
They have literally tied his feet and his hands into the rope. I don't understand what's going on. Why are they doing this?
Just like Chris.
Well, I don't know. It's obvious to me that the Lightning Kid.
Look at this. The Lightning Kid is handing him.
He's handing him money, Joey.
$100 bills. That looks like $100 bills. Wait a minute. Now I know what's going on. This is a whole plot to get Chaz. The Lightning Kid is paying the Davis brothers to put Chaz out. There's a DDT.
All right. My goodness.
Now, look at that. Powerbomb. And there's a chair in the ring. Obviously, they are being paid.
The whole works, Joe. This is it. This is it.
The Lightning Kid is paying the Dirty Davis brothers to hurt Chaz. There's no doubt about it.
They're going for it, Joe.
They're all working on the leg, and now they've got this chair. Wait a minute.
Hey, what's this?
Here comes Tug Taylor down to the ring.
What an unbelievable circumstance, but I can't believe this.
Tug Taylor has come down to the ring.
Oh, I don't know what he's
doing. They're tying, and Taylor's taking money.
Oh, sure.
Taylor's taking money from the Lightning Kid. If he comes off the top rope on the leg of Chaz, Chaz could be injured for the rest of his life. They've got one of his legs tied up in a chair.
What an expertise. What a plan.
And now Taylor is going to the top rope. If he comes off on Chaz, it could end the career. Wait a minute.
What's happened?
He qualifies the Davis brothers. He's body slamming the Davis brothers, and there's a drop kick. He took the money from the Lightning Kid, and now he punches the Lightning Kid. The Lightning Kid's plan has backfired for some reason. Tug Taylor has decided to help Chaz. Garvin doesn't know what's going on. Terry Garvin is at a loss, so am I. Tug Taylor took the money, but then turned around and helped Chaz.
I don't understand it, Joe.
They are